two final notes that you need to know about the absolute basics of Touch Designer are related to keyboard shortcuts, and this trips up a lot of new users. So the first is that keyboard shortcuts only work while your mouse is inside of the network editor. So what do I mean by that? So let's take a look at two keyboard shortcuts we looked at already. If I hit I and I have this G01 selected, I'll go inside of it. If I hit U, I go back up a level. Now that's working, like I said, because my mouse is inside the network editor. But what if I move my mouse over the timeline and I hit I, U? You can see no matter what I'm doing, none of these keyboard shortcuts are working because my mouse is outside of the network editor. And this is the same, you know, I can take it to the top over here, start hitting I or U, move it around, hitting I or U. But once I kind of bring it into that network editor, all of a sudden it starts working. So that's an important thing because you don't want to have your mouse like hanging around somewhere and you're trying to hit your keyboard shortcuts and you're struggling to figure out why those keyboard shortcuts aren't working. The same thing can be said about caps lock, which also trips up a lot of new users, is that if accidentally your caps lock gets turned on, this actually changes many of the keyboard shortcuts to be variations of them. But also for some of the basic ones that we use, they stop working completely. So for example, I just turned caps lock off. So if I hit I and U, everything works as expected. If I turn caps lock back on and I hit I and U, even though my mouse is inside of this network, it's not doing anything until I turn caps lock back off and my kind of functionality returns back to normal. For 90% of your keyboard shortcuts, you're gonna want caps lock off. There's a few that, you know, we're not even gonna look at in this one because they're really more advanced, but it's just something you need to be aware of.